Khushi.
Hello, Dhami.
Do you ready to our project?
Oh my god, I forget it.
No, what are we do? We want to present it tomorrow.
I have an idea. Come with me.
Oh wow, where are we in?
We are in the past.
Oh.
Hello.
Who are you?
I am a scientist. Who are you?
We all come from the future. We come to find information for our project.
Do you know how the Earth was origin?
Nebula theory is one and only theory we know.
According to this theory, planets and galaxies were formed by clumping small particles together by gravity. Dhani, do you think this theory is the correct theory about origin of the Earth?
No, I don't agree with that.
Yes, according to the modern scientific explanations, it is proved that the Big Bang theory is the correct theory about origin of the Earth. According to this theory, the universe was a large place with a great amount of energy. One day, an explanation took place and small particles were created. After that, they clumped up together and made planets and galaxies. Do you know what's our galaxy? It is the Milky Way.
Initial Earth was a very hot object and it contains various types of gases and elements. By the joining of these various elements, compounds such as water was formed. This water is helped to cool down the modern initial Earth and modern Earth was created.
Do you know how the life on Earth was originated? We believe that the life on Earth was originated 3.5 billion years ago. According to our exploration, the life was originated according to the theory of special creation. That means all the living things, including humans, plants and animals, were created according to supernatural power.
No, that is not correct theory. The correct theory is spontaneous generation theory. It is explained that the life on the Earth originated spontaneously from non-living things. Examples: rats who grown from piece of cloth, maggots who grown from rotten meat.
No, it's not the correct theory. The correct path to prove that spontaneous generation theory is not an acceptable theory. Cosmic theory is the correct theory. This theory said that living organisms were arrived to the Earth by a spacecraft or by an asteroid.
What? Do you think those theories are correct? The scientist Stanley Miller proved that the biochemical evolution theory is the correct theory. According to this theory, life was created by a set of chemicals that act as the basic ingredients of life. The energy required for recreation is given by a set of electric discharges.
By the biochemical evolution, it is proved that all the living organisms were created. There was a common ancestor, and by this ancestor, all the living organisms were created. Do you know the mollusks and annelid are the first groups that were created on the Earth? The two scientists called Holden and Oparin put forward the biochemical evolution theory, and it is scientifically proved by the scientist called Stanley Miller.
Now, we are going to talk about the evolution tree. This is the tree of evolution. Our common ancestor was a microorganism. You can see here that our common ancestor is a microorganism. For various parts, our evolution will occur. Here, the first organism was fish called coelacanth, then frogs, dinosaurs, horse, Avis group, gorilla and this, and finally the man was evolved. When we talk about this part, there were many organisms and scorpion, dragonfly and finally the beetle. When we talk about the part of the evolution of the tree, there are several plants in this picture, so we can identify the evolution is very different from plants and animals.
Now let us talk about evolution of the human. Gradual development of simple organism to modern complex organism is the evolution. Humans was originated about 12
billion years ago and modern humans was originated about 5 million years ago.
There are three main evidence to show the evolution process occur naturally. First one, evidence from geographical animal distribution. Second one, evidence from comparative anatomy. Third one, evidence from fossil study.
Here is something.
The honey? Do you know what's this?
No. What's that?
I don't know what's this.
Girls, I know what is this. Do you know what is this? This is a fossil. What is a fossil? Fossil means preserved animal or plant material found during excavations. There are several examples for fossils too.
Hard part of an animal such as skeleton, teeth or shells. The external skeleton of some insects are preserved in three regions of fossils.
Now let's see what are living fossils. The organisms and plants which are not evolved during million years ago and their properties are does not change throughout this time period. These types of animals and plants are called living fossils. Examples, cockroach, dragonfly, lingula,
and also lungfish, coelacanth and typhon called guinea otter. Do you know the time of the fossils estimated by radioactive carbon?
The evolutionary process of who's? Do you know why to study about the evolutionary process of hosts? It is important to study about the evolutionary process of hosts because we found the old fossils from the simple organism to modern complex organism. In this picture, you can see the first stage of the host and the modern stage of the host. So it is very important to study about the evolutionary process of hosts. So it is proved that evolution is different from various animals.
Now we are talking about importance of evolution in biodiversity. There is a huge comparative among animals. For limited resources, this is comparative decrease by biodiversity. Various animals are evolving from current. The species that is known as speciation.
Now I'm going to give something for your extra knowledge. Do you know Charles Darwin is considered as the father of evolution?
Dhani, I think those informations are enough for our project.
Yes.
Thank you very much for helping us today.
Do you like to come with us to the future?
Of course, that's a good idea.
Okay,
let's go to the future!